My guest tonight is a talented actor who you may actually know best from his days with New Kids on the Block. Remember this? Well, he's no longer a kid, and now his acting career has taken off with his pivotal role in the summer blockbuster, The Sixth Sense. Please welcome Donnie Wahlberg. Great to have you here. Congratulations on the success of the movie. You leave a lasting impression with your role in this film.
Really?
And I know we can't talk too much about it, because you've got to be careful not to give too many things away, but can you tell us a little bit about it?
Well, basically, I play a character who was a former patient of Bruce Willis, and probably I'm the one patient who he didn't have any success in helping, and I sort of pay him a visit in the film and to show him the results of him not helping me. And what happens with me sort of inspires him to go out and find a patient similar to me at a similar age to when he treated me, and that is the main little boy in the film. And he goes out and sort of dedicates his life to helping this boy to make up for the mistakes he made with my character.
And that guy did a great job of acting,
he's
too.
He's good. Haley Joel Osment.
Yeah, great job.
Man, he's incredible.
And so do you, but I understand we don't have any footage that we can show. What's the reason for that?
See, there's rules about what you can show, and my wardrobe in the film doesn't really allow for me to be shown in, on any TV shows or really in the trailer or anything, because it's really not much of a wardrobe.
Just means that people who haven't seen the film yet, you have to go see him in this role. I mean, you're the thing that you remember, so it's great.
Well, thank
and you did a lot to prepare for this. You spent 5 weeks preparing for one day of work. Tell us what you did.
Yeah, it was supposed to be 2 days of work, but I just dedicated myself to the role. I mean, I was playing a character that was nothing like me. It was someone who's been suffering his whole life. You know, like, he sees ghosts too. And he's done everything he can his whole life to hide and get away, including use every type of drug he could get his hands on and do whatever. And basically, for me to play this role, I couldn't just show up, you know, and coming from my current lifestyle, and just show up and try to play this role. So I had to sort of let go of things that I had. And I basically took 5 weeks and just went out and stayed in a little apartment in New York with no money, no credit cards, no food, and lost 40 pounds for the role.
Lost
and
just 40 pounds?
Well, it, you know what it was? It was important for me to suffer.
Lost
and to
40
really,
pounds?
Yeah, 40 pounds.
Wow.
And like 30 less than I am now. So, I mean, I really didn't have anything to lose.
No.
But I lost whatever I could.
I'm sorry, but I'm looking at you.
Yeah.
You're a muscular guy, but you're not that big. So
no,
like
I'm not
40
that big.
Pounds.
Yeah, I was about 30 pounds lighter than I am now.
Man.
So it was pretty dramatic. And I really didn't have to act. You know, I just showed up and
because you were that guy for 5 weeks,
well, I became it. I mean, you know, I started out saying, well, let me lose some weight and let me look more like someone who's been on drugs for a while. But as I got into the process and really started going through it, I started to really suffer. And I would lie alone in bed at night. You know, I didn't really talk to anybody. And I sort of became one with this character and suffered in a way that made me be able to give a true performance, which the film deserved. You know, the script that I read deserved a true performance.
That is dedication. I mean, actors that are getting millions of dollars don't even do stuff to that extent.
Don't.
So good for
you. Right.
You
know,
well, it was obviously worth it, right?
It was worth it. It was worth it for me in ways that I can't even explain. I mean, spiritually, I mean, when you're that alone and you suffer that much, I mean, all I really had during that period was God. And my relationship with God really strengthened during that time. So.
Oh, good for you. Yeah. So the shooting day is over.
Yeah, it's over.
You don't have to be this guy anymore.
Right.
What do you do?
Eat.
Eat?
Eat. Oh, man, I ate Honeycombs, In-N-Out Burger, Wendy's Spicy Chicken Sandwich. man, I ate everything. Cheese steaks, yeah.
Non-stop, huh?
I ate good.